Let's play a little game. I will show you a bunch of letters on a screen. You'll see them for a few seconds, then I will remove them. Now write them down. How many did you remember? If you're like most people, it's probably about 7 plus or minus 2. This is what the magical number 7 refers to. It's the capacity of human short-term memory, the amount of information that people can remember without study and rehearsal. Now, let's play this game again with a different set of letters. Now write down as many as you can remember. Feel free to pause the video in order to do so. How many letters did you recall this time? Most people remember around 7 words in experiments like this. That means about 3 times 7 equals 21 letters. A lot more letters than in our first experiment. Why is that? How come the size of your short-term memory suddenly got bigger? Back in the late 1950s, the psychologist George Miller reviewed several studies of human memory and noticed that in all of them, people could remember 7 plus or minus 2 items. Hence the magical number 7 plus or minus 2, the title of his paper. But for Miller, this wasn't the interesting part. This being the era of information theory, he was fascinated by the fact that the unit, the type of items that could be remembered, was different in different studies. In some studies, people remembered 7 letters, in others 7 numbers or words. Thus, he figured that the capacity of short-term memory shouldn't be measured in bits, the traditional unit for information, but rather in meaning units called chunks. And these units could be as big as one would want. So that means you can increase the size of your short-term memory as long as you group items into meaningful chunks. Characters into words, words in sentences, digits in numbers, and so on. A process known as chunking. It's a principle that you may have encountered before when you try to memorize information. Now, keep in mind, the major implication of the magical number 7 is that you can expect people to keep roughly 7 items of information in their short-term memory. So they won't remember things like random coupon codes, links that they may have visited before, password requirements, or lots of instructions. Now, the magical number 7 is often invoked as an argument in UX wrongly. I've heard people using it to argue for 7 items in a menu bar or in a pull-down menu, 7 bullet points on a slide, 7-point rating scales. The truth is, the human short-term memory capacity is not relevant for these tasks. You're not supposed to remember all options in the menu or all the bullets on a slide or all the points on a rating scale. They are normally visible or accessible, and there could be other good reasons for which you may not want to have too many, but the magical number 7 is not one of them.